Belarus Free Theater will now present a half an hour piece. This is the third part of Zone of Silence 3-hour performance. Don't get scared, it will not take 3 hours. Just half an hour, but I wish you could see the whole performance. But it's called Numbers, and actors of Belarus Free Theater thought about Belarus by their bodies. You will see just numbers on Belarus, what's happening in Belarus, but just in numbers, if it makes any sense. The performance is called Zone of Silence, director of the performance, Vladimir Sherbin, and after the piece, I would introduce all actors to you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Redne Laterne und steht sie noch davor. Da wollen wir uns wiedersehen. Bei der Laterne wollen wir stehen. Ooh.
Пол не чуя под собою, между небом и землею, как во сне с тобой танцую. Аромат духов так манит, опьяняет и дурманит. Ах, как сладко в нем тону я. Так близки наши тела и безумные слова. Без стыда тебе шепчу я. Ах, какая женщина, какая...
Thank you. не хочу, но разве там не до спотканья, до сустрэчи? Я тебе кажу, на развитание, на споткання, на сустрэчи.
Мы белорусы,
мирны,
я люди сердцем отдавны.
Щира в руку ем сили,
дугу
ем
мир,
праця
іде
і вольнайся.
Совет безопасности единодушно высказался за строительство АЭС. Это как выстрел из стартового пистолета, давший сигнал новому этапу развития ядерной энергетики в Беларуси. Такую спортивную лексику употребил заместитель председателя президиума Национальной академии наук, доктор технических наук Владимир Тимошпольский, подчеркивая значимость принятого президентом указа номер 565 о некоторых мерах по строительству атомной электростанции. До этого президент не раз обращался к ядерной теме, в том числе выступая на первом съезде ученых страны. И вот, выбор сделан. Запущен механизм реализации глобального энергетического проекта. В Минэнерго сообщили, что сейчас идет подготовительный этап работ. Предполагается, что первый блок АЭС будет введен в 2016-2017 годах, второй в 2020. По прогнозам, стоимость строительства АЭС составит 3-4 миллиарда долларов из расчета на два энергоблока мощностью 1 миллион мегаватт каждый. Поставщик энергоблоков определится через тендер, хотя ученые говорят о высокой вероятности его выигрыша российскими партнерами. Я на 99% уверен, что это будет все-таки Российская Федерация, откровенно заявил Владимир Тимошпольский. Подводя итоги, президент подчеркнул, что теперь, когда окончательное решение принято, необходимо максимально ускорить темпы подготовки к строительству.
Вернусь, широй, зязюляй, сяду за дом.
Vladimir Sherbin is director of this performance. Денис Тарасенко, Павел Городницкий, Яна Русакевич, Марина Юревич, Олег Сидорчик, and just this young...
I'm Nikolai Khalizin and Natalia.
Her husband was arrested today, so forgive us for this.
I'm Larry Seams. I direct the Freedom to Write and International Programs at Pan American Center. Thank you. A couple of words of thanks and a final word. Many, many thanks to Le Poisson Rouge and especially to Dustin Nelson. Thank you so much. To Carol Llewellyn and to my Penn colleagues, Jakob Orsos, Elizabeth Weinstein, and Sarah Hoffman. To all of tonight's participants for being so generous with their time and their voices, Billy, Margaret, and Eva, Don DeLillo and E.L. Doctorow, who are always there when writers and creative freedom are threatened. And especially Tom Stoppard, who is another one of those who is always there and who is absolutely the driving force behind this evening. Belarus really is an old school dictatorship, and what has been happening there this past month is outrageous. And it hits very close to home for Penn. The office of Belarusian Penn in Minsk was raided a couple of weeks after last month's election, and its computers and papers were seized. Vladimir Nikolaev, who dared to run against Lukashenko and whose beautiful poems we heard tonight, is a former president of Belarusian Penn. He and two other Penn members, Pavel Severenets and Alexander Fyoduta, have been held in old school KGB prisons and will stand trial next month on specious charges of organizing riots, charges that could land them 23 years in prison. Your presence here tonight is a gesture of solidarity with them and with all the writers, artists, journalists, and intellectuals now being targeted in Belarus. On their behalf, thank you, and thank you for your support for Penn. We will not let up until they are free. I want to say, though, that the right of freedom of expression under international law is not just the right to speak and create freely in your own community. It also guarantees the right of all of us here in this room to hear and to read and to listen to what someone is saying or creating anywhere in the world. When a Belarusian poet is silenced, it violates our right to hear her. When the Belarusian Free Theater is silenced, it violates our right to see them. Standing up for freedom of expression in Belarus is not a selfless act on our part. So, thank you to the Belarus Free Theater for your work, your courage, and your inspiration, and for making full our right to freedom of expression. And thanks to all of you for coming out tonight in this wonderful show of support. As you know, the proceeds from the tickets tonight are going to the Belarus Free Theater. We also have a table set up on the way out with donation information. Please know that if you care to and can contribute more to support this amazing group, even just a few dollars, it will be most welcome and gratefully received. Now, We have the room for another 30 minutes. The Belarus Free Theater will be here. Please stay, meet them, buy them drinks, and enjoy yourselves. And thank you all very much for coming.